This is Gabriela Ortiz for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you a new feature in Stata 16 for fitting nonparametric series regression models. Nonparametric series estimation models an outcome variable as a function of the covariates. The function of the covariates is known as a basis function. You can use a polynomial basis, a spline basis, or a B-spline basis. The models fit with npregress series allow you to be agnostic about the functional form between the outcome and the covariates, and therefore they are not subject to misspecification error. But you can impose some structure on your model, for example, by specifying that the unknown function is additive or specifying that a variable enters the function linearly. With npregress series, you can obtain average marginal effects for continuous variables and contrast for discrete variables. With nonparametric series regression, we are approximating an unknown mean function with a basis function. The key is choosing the optimal number of terms to include in the basis function. For example, if I use a polynomial basis, I can use a second-order polynomial, a third-order polynomial, and up to a 16th-order polynomial. We can use any of the following criteria to select the optimal number of terms in the basis function. To demonstrate how to fit a nonparametric series regression model in Stata, I've loaded a dataset on the number of drunk driving citations. I'd like to model the mean number of citations as a function of drunk driving fines and whether there is a college in the jurisdiction. To fit this model, I can go to Statistics and select Nonparametric Analysis and Nonparametric Series Regression. Here I'll specify the dependent variable citations and then the independent variables fines, which is a continuous variable, and college, which is an indicator variable. And I'll be performing cubic B-spline estimation. So now I can click OK to fit this model. So this is the command I could have typed npregress series. And I see in the header of the output that the cross-validation criterion was used, and one knot was selected for the cubic B-spline estimation. The output reports the average marginal effect for continuous variables and contrast for discrete variables. Here I see a comparison between jurisdictions with and without a college. And I see that on average, increasing the fine for drunk driving reduces the number of citations. But I can examine this more closely with margins. For example, I can compute the expected number of citations for counterfactual fine amounts. So I can go to Statistics, and then I'll select Post-Estimation and Marginal Effects, and then I'll select Basic and Low Dimensional Analysis. Here I'll specify the continuous variable fines, and then I'll specify the fine amounts. I want to know how many citations we can expect if every jurisdiction imposed a drunk driving fine of $8,000, $9,000, $10,000, and even $11,000. And note that I'm simply typing 8 through 11 because fines is recorded in thousands of dollars. So now I can click OK. And I see that this is the margins command I could have typed. I see that if every jurisdiction imposed a drunk driving fine of $8,000, we would expect an average of 45 citations. However, if every jurisdiction imposed a fine of $11,000, we would expect an average of only 14 citations. And I can visualize this by typing margins plot. And here I get a graph of those values. There's a lot more you can do after fitting a model with npregress series. For example, you can estimate conditional means, population and subpopulation means, and graph these values along with their confidence intervals. You can also test different hypotheses. If you would like to learn more about the new npregress series command in Stata 16, you can download the manual from our website at stata.com. Thank you for watching.